Project Swachh.
Hello everybody, welcome back to New Delhi Nature Society's program Project Swachh. Today we're going to interview Pradip Krishen and listen to his views on restoring degraded habitats. So welcome to our show. Let me start by lighting the incense. So tell us something about yourself.
I've been working, the big project I've been working on for the last 10 or 11 years now has been in Jodhpur, where essentially I've worked at trying to restore an extremely rocky habitat in the desert. So not only does it not have soil, very little rain, and it was invaded by Vilaithi Kikar, which as everybody knows is a highly invasive plant. So essentially that's what I've been doing for the last 10 or 11 years. I'm now handling a lot of other projects as well. One in Ahmedabad, one on the bridge that's about to start here in Delhi. Possibly a very big project in Jaipur at the edge of the city. But it's all about trying to restore habitats that are wasted in some way and trying to bring back what we think would have been the natural ecology of those places.
And tell us something about your organization.
Well, I don't have an organization. I've been working alone so far. I now team up with people. So the Jaipur project, when it happens, will be with me and three other friends of mine who all think in similar ways, but they're architects, they're, you know, plants people. But I don't really have an organization at all.
Okay. And along your journey, the problems and solutions that you've come across?
Well, you know, essentially because we don't have a long history of people who are ecological restorers in these countries, we've had to find our own solutions and make our mistakes and learn from our mistakes. So when I first started working in Jodhpur, I'd been working in small ways in a number of other places. Essentially charting one's own path, making mistakes as I said. I think the important thing was to learn very quickly that if you choose the right kinds of plants, which are always plants that are native to those particular ecologies, that's half the battle. That's nearly half the battle. Because plants that are completely at home, are completely adapted to those soil conditions, that moisture regime, that kind of climate, survive very easily and survive without large inputs, either in terms of watering or fertilizer or nutrients of any kind. So if you start thinking native plants, you've actually won half your battle, even before you begin.
Yeah, that's very important. We see a lot of ornamental plants which don't belong in a native environment.
You know, I think it's important not to be too biased against ornamental plants, because all plants ultimately were once wild plants, you know.
Yeah.
It's just that people sometimes make the wrong choices. So there's no, I personally think that, for example, if you were to use in Delhi a tree like the Tabebuia aurea, which is Brazilian, it's not a native plant at all, but it does come from very, very dry ecologies, you know. It's probably a plant that wouldn't do any harm at all. So it's not as though the fact that it's ornamental is wrong. What's wrong really is the fact that they need to belong to that particular landscape, that particular ecology, you know. And the fact is, the last book I wrote, which is 2 years ago, which is called The Jungle Trees of Central India, I'm actually advocating that there are at least 30 or 40 trees out there in the jungle that have never been tried in cities, you know, as ornamental trees. I think that they deserve a place purely for their ornamental value. But the fact is they're wild, and they come from a particular kind of soil, you know, a soil regime and a moisture regime and a climate regime. Mm-hmm. And unless that is suitable, there's no point trying to, you wouldn't bring in a polar bear to Delhi and then put it in a zoo and then have to build a, you know, a refrigerated room to house it, right? So shouldn't do that for a tree either.
Yeah. And so would you like to share a special message for the viewers?
Well, you know, I think that one of the things that I notice is that the way landscape architects, at least in this part of India, the way they think and the way they respond to what they say their clients want is to go for evergreen, is to go for palms. And the model, unfortunately, I find this very sad, the model, unfortunately, you know, is the kind of palms that you see in Dubai and Sharjah. And the fact that they're trying to make a place like Delhi or Lucknow or, you know, any of these other cities look like Sharjah, Dubai is a very, very sad statement, I think, on how much they know about plants and how much they know about what is suitable. So I think a very important message that I'd like to tell people out there is, please don't think of evergreen as being a desirable outcome. You know, well, the natural state of a tree in this kind of ecology that is governed by the monsoon is to shed its leaves and to go dormant for 2 or 3 months in the year as a way of conserving moisture. That is the natural ecology, the natural behavior of a tree here. I think we should accept it and love the trees for it, because they also have a lot of beautiful things that they do as a result. For example, new leaf is a beautiful event in our dry and deciduous jungles, you know? Farms don't have that. Yeah. So discard this business about looking only for evergreen trees. Let the sun come through dry branches in winter and celebrate new leaf and celebrate the leafiness of these lovely trees in summer.
There's so many different flowers coming out around this time.
It's a gorgeous time of the year. It's a lovely time of the year.
Thank you for joining our show today.
You're welcome.
And please like our video and subscribe for more inspirational videos. Thank you. Project Swachh.